Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Cameron here. Welcome back to another video. Today's actually a really good one because I'm going to be showing you guys how I managed to get 10 llamas in 10 different games in a row by spotting them in the actual battle bus, not even dropping. I'm going to share all the clips with you guys. There's quite a few of them, so I don't know if I'll get every single one of them in this video, but it was insane. Like 10 games in a row, I kept finding a llama right at the start of the game. In some cases, we even found two, one for me and my wife that I was playing with, my other duo. So yeah, guys, this is a good one. You guys want to stay tuned for it because I'm also going to show you guys all the settings that are optimal for finding llamas. But yeah, real quick, guys, if you're brand new to the channel, if you don't mind hitting that subscribe button, we're on our way to 3K and we're blowing up big time on this channel and it means a lot to me. First off, I wanted to show you guys my optimal settings, what I think is the best settings for finding a llama, and this does work for console, although the names of the settings will be a little different on console. So yeah, just taking a look into the settings here, you're gonna want to make sure you got your view distance on Epic. This is gonna allow you to see extremely far, and you'll be able to see llamas in the battle bus. It's super easy to spot them when you have Epic for your view distance. Don't really worry about all these other ones like the shadows, anti-aliasing, textures, effects, and post-processing, because it really doesn't make any impact on finding a llama easier. Other than that, those settings are basically the best. Make sure you got 100% for your 3D resolution and all that. But this is kind of what I like. I think that these settings here work the best. You'll take a look here at the graphic settings that I got. I have my brightness all the way up just so that way dark spots are very bright on my screen, and I think that that helps out quite a bit. I wouldn't worry anything about the interference or interface contrast, doesn't really affect it much. The colorblind mode I noticed that makes purple pop the most is Deuteranope. You can't really see it very well here because there's not really that much purple. Well, there's this. But you'll notice how light purple looks compared to all these other colors. So it just makes it that much easier to spot it. So I have mine set up on Deuteranope, and then I have the strength on about 6, and I think that that's pretty optimal. Alright, guys, well, that's basically it for the settings, but stay tuned because I'm going to share with you guys some amazing clips of actually spotting llamas in the battle bus. Let's check it out.
You tell me where there's a llama, and then we'll jump.
Okay, looking, looking, looking. I don't see one. Fuck, I don't see one. Oh,
Okay,
wait,
Craig,
that's one.
close
Found
enough.
one.
Where, Mark?
Come on. There it is.
I'll go to weather station then.
That was a close one. I almost didn't get one that time.
I was like, all right, did find one, let's go Craggy. They're usually near each other, so I was looking for another one, but there was none.
Hurry, 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 hurry.
It's gonna be over here. Let's go Slurpee. There's gonna be one when we rift. When we start floating over there, you'll find it.
Okay.
You always do.
I found one, but it's in Risky.
Oh, that's a bad. Too many people are too low. They're already gonna get it.
Maybe not. No, nobody's landing.
They
There.
passed by. I know they passed by it. I was like, what?
I'm clipping it. It's going in my llama video. And I see a llama. It's right here. Oh, damn it. Now that I know how to spot them every game, now I can't land wherever I want. You just did it, huh?
Yeah.
Proud of that little guy.